All right, there we go. Hello, everybody. Another episode of TEW 2016 here for Hawkeye Pro Wrestling. We just got done with Infamous 37. We're now on to Infamous 38. Brett Hull probably sponsor you. Maybe. Oh, God. People are going to be gone. That's not good. Sunday. That's, oh, God. Sundays are starting to become less viable. Alright, looking at the schedule, I'm gonna say week 3, I guess, is the best shot I have at doing another show. I wasn't planning on doing it so quickly. I always wanted to, you know, make sure to keep doing it, but if Tama Tonga, Tangaloa, Kushida, and Omega are all gone in Japan on the day I would normally do it, I guess I don't really have much of a choice but to do it on Sunday. So I guess I'll do it a week early. Why not? Dude, I really need people to kind of, like, leave their promotions sooner rather than later, because I need promotions to start tanking behind me so that I have so that I can actually have days where everyone can be there to work. Yeah, I think that's about the best I can do. Bring your issues with Sue back up. I want to screen cap it. Everything that I've done to try to not piss her off. There you go. There's a nice screen cap for you. She was pissed off at the booking of a match 6 months ago. You see those bonuses? Those are $1,000 bonuses. I actually threw... there's three bonuses. I actually threw $1,000 a piece, so I gave her $3,000 of stop being pissed off at me money, and she's still pissed off at me. Like, here's a bonus. Just stop. Yeah. Jessica Havoc's the same way. I gave her $3,000 of stop being pissed off at me money. And she's still, like, all full of piss and vinegar. Bolt Brady just doesn't like the fact that I'm not giving him money. He's not worth, like, $700 an event. And if he pushes the issue, I'll just fucking toss him. That's why I have a short list. So I can just bring in new people. That is something I want to do. I want to try bringing in maybe some new people. Let me see. Maybe I should look into doing that by Sunday. Just someone kind of new. I don't know. Wasn't it Naito that said he could? Okay, we're too small for Naito still. I think once we get to be Colt, that'll be different. But, I mean, he was fucking great. Maybe we should look into Yano. Yano will work with us. I should really do that. Like, we didn't get Naito, but we can get Yano. That might work, actually. How much is he charging me? $1,400 is not really all that much for someone like Yano. I don't think he knows English. Pretty sure he doesn't know English. Yeah. But he's dependable, social, extremely loyal. He would be a positive influence in most locker rooms. We should do that. Fuck it, we'll find a place for Yano. I want to see if I can get away with not having to cover his travel. Let's see what happens. I think I might be... I think it seems to have worked out. It worked out with Tozawa. Let's see if Yano's not too big to make me not have to pay for his flight. I think in reality, if I really wanted him, I'd be paying for his flight. But let's see if I can get out of doing that. Because that'd be like $750 an event to bring him in. Like an extra $750. You're going to Naito about wrestling? Naito. Yeah, that's a top wrestler right now. there we go. Yeah. We're making an international issue, though. We're going to Naito to make it an international issue that we have so many people show up and that we... have people who need to leave their promotions. This is Yano telling me to fuck off. Nope, Lufisto. I didn't offer anything to her yet, so let's just keep going. Nick Gage. We should bring in Nick Gage. I'm sure he'd be a positive influence to the locker room. I'm sure he'd just be great. By the way, can they simulate? I'm sure they can simulate because they have the law problems thing in here. I'm sure they could simulate Nick Gage constantly being in jail. I should just look into that. How much would it take? How much does Nick Gage want? By the way, Magnus is one of the Hulkamaniac fuckers. Gage isn't willing to work with me. Why? Oh, he's on hiatus. He's on hiatus, quote unquote. That means prison. Yeah. You can go to prison in this game, and Nick Gage is literally in there. Let me see. We're still waiting on Yano's response. Oh yeah, we can get Dan Shokudino. It's another Japanese guy we can bring in. Nothing says ratings quite like Dan Shokudino versus Toru Yano. All right, Kushida extends his deal. Sure, whatever. And Yano. Yes! Yano is willing to have me not pay for his fucking flight here. That is awesome. Good. That'll save me some money. I'm a cheap motherfucker, I'll tell you that much. Alright. How big... let's just do the auto push and see where he lands on the hierarchy. What's the hierarchy look like now that we have Toru Yano? Yano lands in upper mid card. That pushed Redman down to mid card. That pushes Kenny Omega further down to mid card. Yano isn't smart. Maybe it's all those DVD sales. He doesn't have to worry. He doesn't have to worry about paying for his own flights because of all those DVD and T-shirt sales. All the shilling finally worked out for him. Not football porn. They should make a porn industry version of this. she did. But I was just about to ask myself if he should be a heel, but like Yano is literally nothing more than like born to be a heel. Let me see. I just know he's best at being a weasel, but I might as well look and see. Oh no, he's actually not great at being a weasel. What? That's. I call shenanigans on this. I call shenanigans on this fucking... this bullshit mod. This real-world mod is bullshit. Toru Yano should be like an A-fucking-plus weasel. That's all Toru Yano is fucking weaselly heel. He's not a fucking brute. Bullshit. Bullshit. I call shenanigans. Oh my god. Just make Toru Yano something completely different than what he usually is. Just make him a badass. Toru Yano. MMA star. Do they have MMA star in here? That'd be amazing. Trying to see what would work for him. First of all, oh shit. I accidentally hooked my microphone wire into my chair. There we go. He could be a demon hunter. Oh man, what should he do? He could be a gatekeeper. Nation of Violence. Give him Samoa Joe's Nation of Violence gimmick. Would be absolutely amazing. Samoan Savage. God damn it. The Muscle. Fuck it, dude. The idea of Toru Yano being the Muscle is like the best thing ever to me. To the guys who don't normally watch wrestling, to the guys who aren't normally here, the reason that I'm laughing is This is Toru Yano. This is Toru Yano right here. So him being the hired muscle is like the funniest thing in the world to me. So we'll see how this goes. He is quite the guy, yeah. This guy is our new hired muscle. So yeah. I think that's about the best picture to accompany telling people about Toru Yano. Yeah. Just showing off his amazing physique. By the way, I guess he somehow got toned in this game. He somehow actually bulked up. But yeah. Either way, Toru Yano is now the muscle. And now we get to move to Sunday. With our new hired muscle. Dude. He's So Dustin Rhodes comes in as like a sheriff. And this is his hired goon. Like this not really a goon, because it's more like a justice type thing. Like he's the face guy fighting for justice. So that's what Dustin Rhodes should have. He needs to have a Well no, because Yano's a heel, so I don't know. We'll find a place for Yano. Nothing. Oh my god. We should have him and Shane Hollister team up. Because Shane Hollister's kind of taken over the cheating weasel type deal. So him and Hollister would probably be great together. Left wrestler and 1-0 in MMA, I believe. Who left wrestling? Yano doesn't seem like a PWG increased their broadcast quality, HGTV, their music level to license, their live event experience to professional. Have a legit wrestler in 1-0 in MMA? Is he really? Like, I gotta check up on that shit now. Mixed martial arts record. He's not 1-0, he's 0-1. He did do mixed martial arts, but he's 0-1. And he did that MMA match back in August 31st, 2003. But yeah, according to Wikipedia, he is 0-1 in mixed martial arts. When he lost his only MMA fight, or at least professional MMA fight. I don't know about amateur, but professional MMA fight in the Pancrase 10th anniversary show in 2003. So, quite the change in the last 10 years. Let's see, Patrick Clark wants more money. Oh my god. God damn it. Alright. So, $40,000. So, actually, we've kind of pulled ourselves together pretty quickly already. The fact that we're at negative 82,000 in performance means we've already made like 50 grand this month. So, nice. But was a Greco-Roman wrestler that period in New Japan was awkward? Was he like doing like the legit wrestler gimmick in New Japan around this time? Like when Nakamura was like legit like MMA, like when Nakamura was MMA Nakamura, was Toru Yano like fucking MMA Toru Yano? Because the idea of MMA Toru Yano coming out and basically being Shibata is just, it's fantastic to me to imagine him being out there like fucking Shibata and just doing that shit. What are you doing? Nakamura and Machida were going to be the next Inokis. Machida went MMA. Nakamura went wrestling. So there was a point where he was wrestler serious, Yano. Damn. I can only imagine how good Serious Yano. I need to look that up after this. Like Serious Yano. Lots of Supremes and grinding matches, huh? I like the idea that like both Nakamura and Machida were both groomed to go to, like, they're both groomed to be the next Inokis. And I'm almost kind of wondering what like both wrestling and suplexes. I'm almost kind of wondering if Nakamura and Machida like switched roles. Like, I can't imagine Machida being like Nakamura. And I don't know if Nakamura would have been as successful as Machida. Like, he was like 3-2, I think, is what his record was, but I don't know if Nakamura would have ended up in UFC. It'd have been interesting. But I just couldn't see Lyoto Machida like doing his shtick. yeah, definitely the Sanctuary. I don't know why they're like, hey, we're just gonna go ahead and... Oh, cool! Oh, that's why! That's why, because we built it, because a wrestling company built it. And, okay, the fans are renowned for being rowdy and pro-wrestling. That's why we had the higher attendance. 3-1 with one no contest, that was it. But, that's okay, that's what the hotbed is, because if you're a pro wrestling promotion building a building that you now own for professional wrestling, of course it's going to attract pro wrestling fans, and of course it's going to be a big deal. So I love the fact that it's a hotbed, which means most of the people that are supposed to, that are scheduled to show up will show up. That's cool. That's pretty sweet. Let me see here. God, how do I want to start this one off? Because we're now towards the end. Nakamura was an average MMA fighter. Machida didn't have the passion for wrestling. That makes sense. It's kind of weird to think about that, though. To think about Nakamura and Machida, like, coming up in something like that together. Basically, both being groomed together in kind of the... same way. That's just kind of weird to think about. It's like, oh yeah, like it's that weird like 6 degrees of separation where you can actually link Nakamura and Machida together, because it's like, oh yeah, they were both like young lions and they were both kind of groomed to be big, and then Machida went one way and Nakamura went another. Yeah, I had no idea that Machida was actually supposed to be like another Inoki. Nakamura certainly will. Nakamura will do his stint in WWE and he'll probably come back as like a 50-year-old man and wrestle like at Wrestle Kingdom like 20 or 25. I don't know how old he'll be at 50. Like, I don't know how long it's gonna be till he's 50. I think he's like 36 or something now, I think. Either way, I'm getting off topic here. How good are we doing? We're doing all right. I feel like we should be doing a lot better. So let me see here. So we did promos last time. Let's do a match. Just a straight up match. You know what? I'm gonna start it up. We're gonna start this hot as fuck. We're gonna start this with straight up fire. Japanese Brazilians for Machida and Inoki. Damn. So yeah, we'll start this straight up 20 minutes. We will make this a thing immediately. Io versus Io Shirai, Jessica Havoc, Hawkeye Pro Women's Championship on the line. Io Shirai getting the win. Let's do... I don't know if she'll be able to pull it off, so we'll just keep it at regular for right now. We're going to keep Havoc strong for right now. Open match. Could these two call it in the ring? I feel like both of them could. 76 and a 75. I think they both have the ability to call this one in the ring. We'll give it a shot. There's not a lot of guys that I have that could probably call matches in the ring. So this is one of those matches where I might as well use it. We'll definitely slow build since we're giving them like 20 minutes at the start of the show. Decisive win? Yeah, decisive win. And I think that's about it. No real interference, nothing like that. Or do I want interference? I'm looking at my matches here. Okay. Let's do botched interference. Jessica Havoc by Kimberly. Now, there's not really an ordeal where they're able to. So Jessica Havoc also gets distracted by, oh god, who's Kimberly in a feud with? Lisa Marie. That's what it was like. Lisa Marie distracted by that. Basically what is actually going to happen is Kimberly is going to try to hit Io. She's going to accidentally hit Havoc. Lisa Marie comes down to interfere because they're doing their whole shtick, which leads to Io Shirai winning and defending the title, and boom. Alright. So, maybe overbooked a little bit for the finish, but I think we'll be okay. I didn't really want Jessica Havoc to just get straight up beat. So, I think that might be the one that might make the most sense. Angle-wise, that's right, we need to do this. That's right. Io Shirai is celebrating her victory when Dash motherfucking Chisako comes back. And she's going to be doing her shit. We'll do selling, because that's the best way to do beatdowns, I guess. We'll make it a full success. This is a little bit different than usual, so. Io celebrates her title win. Dash returns to beat her down. And holds up the belt. Without a word, we've pretty much already booked end of the road. Because someone has not had her rematch yet. I should probably give just a slight injury risk possibility. I don't think it's going to happen, but might as well put it in there. It's probably not good either to have Io Shirai, who's suffering from... what the hell is she suffering from again? She's got a meniscus tear, which, by the way, I found out she's working through a meniscus tear for like the next year. So that's going to be a thing for at least a year. So she's working through a meniscus tear, defending the title, and then in a beatdown angle as well. So, yeah. Hey, Jack. How's it going? Let's see here. So, Dash came back. We haven't quite used Marty for anything yet. I think right now we're going to keep Dash kind of by herself. The thing with Marty we'll have later. Yeah, I think that's what we'll wait. We'll wait until, I think, end of the road is probably when I'm going to bring Marty Skrull back. So, let's see here. Alright, so we did the whole Joe Redmond thing at the end of the last show. So we got Redmond. Let's do Dario. And Dustin Rhodes. Dario's in. Redmond is in Dario's office. wants an answer. Wants an answer. Dustin says he'll have a shot tonight against Pete Dunne. I'll just put Dunne. So let's see. Entertainment. We'll take the scripts off all of them. We'll see what happens. There we go. What's happening in G1 tonight? I mean, it is 4:30 when it comes on, so there'll be at least an hour of bullshit matches. Six-man tags and whatnot. You can watch the New Japan Legends go over the Young Boys again. Let's see. So we got the two angles. We can set it for another match here. Oh man. All right. So I don't think we had Cody Hall in a match last event. So we'll have Cody Hall fight tonight. So Cody Hall will be in action. Yuma. So resident jobber against Cody Hall. Just a quick 7 minutes, I guess. Let's see. Are they already on their finals? Shit. Sorry, I kind of want to look at this. I didn't even realize they were all almost already done. Jesus. Naito versus Omega, that sounds pretty sweet. Shibata versus Evil should be a nice day for Shibata. Nagata versus Hanma, that's whatever. YTR versus Yoshihashi is Elgin versus Nakajima should be pretty cool. Yeah. There's a few good matches on there. Is Elgin versus Nakajima like opening that? Shit. I gotta admit, there's a lot of times when I watch Dragon Gate and like I'll watch something that I'm told to watch and then I'll be like, alright, where's the Peter Kasaw match? Okay, so Cody Hall getting that. Cody Hall got the win here. Let's see, should we God. Now, we're not gonna work the crowd because I think we're gonna be doing some pre-show matches. Let's see. I'm trying to see what I want this to be. We'll just do a regular match. He's facing Yuma, so I don't need to care too much about stuff. Decisive win. It's just a regular old match. Why not? Here we go. Cody Hall. What's Patrick Clark at in terms of speaking ability? Oh, dude, Stalker Ichikawa dressed up as Liger was amazing. He can't really talk. Shit. I guess that's why it's opening, basically. Or borderline opening. Cody Hall, Patrick. Oh man, should I really? Let's do Menace, and then what can he do? Not a lot. I gotta be honest, not a lot. Even a selling's kind of shit. God, come on, you're only 22 years old, man. I can work with you. We'll make it entertainment. Cody grabs a mic and complains about being forced in a match. Clark comes out to wish him luck. I don't know. I haven't really gotten Patrick Clark's deal down yet. Not to mention, it's kind of an opening match, and you know what? There's not a whole lot to it right now. Just about 3 minutes, I think, is good enough. Let's see. Games like this are fully wanting you to watch New Japan. Yeah, it's worth it. Let's see. So, one more angle. Let's see what we want. God, what a... Okay. So I need to kind of work on what I want to do with... Alright. We'll work on some of the women's stuff here. There's so many different matches I need to, like, work out right now in my head how I want it to go. So, I think what we'll have here... Which women's feud do we want to focus on? Su Young's alright. We haven't done anything with Katarina Lee yet, so... We'll work on that. Katarina, promo, pre-match, about, oh god, who she face? Mary Dobson, that's what it was. Just a couple minutes. I don't know what exactly she would say. I'm not going to pretend like I would know. But we haven't quite used... Let me see the women's... We didn't use a lot of women last time, so let's see here. Katarina Lee. And she will face... We did Evie, we did Io, Lisa Marie, Mary Dobson. Mayu hasn't had a match yet. Suno, Mayu or Momo? Let's go ahead and do Momo. Why not? There we go. So, Katarina Lee versus Momo. Skill-wise, probably just about 7 minutes is good enough. Has Momo gotten a lot of wins for us yet? From me. I usually try to give her something. One. She's, let's see. What? Stardom barely fucking uses her, by the way. So. I wouldn't be shocked if at some point she didn't feel like staying in, Stardom. Much like Mayu. These are always shit. This isn't the greatest idea in the world, but... That's alright. We'll figure it out. I bet you instead... Well, you know what? Yeah, we'll put Momo in there. Why not? So, Katarina Lee gets it. Domination. It's not really an open match. I guess All Out, just because it's 7 minutes, and we'll see what we can do. I'm not expecting much out of them. Why not a submission finish? Really lay it on thick that Katarina Lee's. Shake, 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 shake. God damn it. This is what happens when I listen to music, is I get into it. And then I listen to the Booty Man's theme and start singing along to it. Ech. That's alright. I chose to have the Booty Man's theme in this, so I will own up to it. So, Katarina Lee, let's do Mary Dobson as well. And I think what I want to do, since Kimberly is also a thing, Lisa Marie. Alright. Let's see. Mary comes out Sorry, I gotta move the mic and everything. Figure out what I'm gonna do. Mary comes out to confront Lee. Kimberly blindsides her. Lisa Marie out. It's a brawl. How about that? That's enough space. So it's just a clusterfuck of women right now. And they're all selling. Because it's just a gigantic brawl. Oops. Success, success. It's pretty much a success for everybody, but there's also slight injury risk here. So, do that there. Let's see. Yep. I did a typo real quick. I did a couple typos. I did the H for dash like Kevin Nash. Like how he had his tights where it's like capital A, capital N, capital S, and then just H, like lowercase h. Like they couldn't afford the rest of the H. Save that there. So we're about 52 minutes in. And I also want to make sure I get in people that I didn't get in last time. So let's see. We haven't used Matt Hardy. Raj Singh. Pete Dunne's going to be later on tonight. Colby. That's right. Colby's definitely getting used. Hang on. First, let me make sure. Cool. Alright, so we want Colby backstage. Cody's there. Colby again confronts Cody about his actions. Cody brushes him off. And shoves him. How about that? Shoves him away. So now there's some real physicality. Like, ah, man. I'm in the fucking Bullet Club. He ain't gonna do shit to me. So, just a couple of quick minutes just to kind of show that this is a thing. Yeah, we'll just leave it there. I'm getting tired. Let's see here. So we've done our angles here. What else do we want? Should we do the Pete Dunne match now or later? So let's see. We haven't used Sarah Lee. Well, Sarah Lee's probably going to be... probably going to be a pre-show person. We'll even put Mayu versus... How about that? I already know what our pre-show match will be. We'll put Mayu up there against Sarah Lee to have just kind of a pisser of a match. 8 minutes pre-show. Easy as pie. Mayu wins. There you go. Make it decisive. So now we've got that out of the way. When was the last time I used some of these people? Let's see. I haven't used Bolt Brady. So we got Bolt Brady. We got Mark Sherman. Sherman's definitely going to be... Let's put Sherman out there. He's our champion, for God's sakes. We haven't really done much with him. He's been kind of absent recently. So Mark Sherman, who is he going to face? You know what? Should we use Yano now, or should we wait till later? I think Yano's an upper mid-card guy, so let's not do that. In fact, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to look for someone locally. I haven't done that in a little while. Let's find someone to job to, someone to job to him. Let's see. I'm looking for great in-ring workers. Mikey Batts and Tony DeVito. Is Mikey Batts literally 32 years old? I don't believe that, because he was like an old school TNA guy like 10 years ago. I refuse to believe that Mikey Batts is only 32 years old. Holy fuckaroni, he's only 32 years old. Dude, he must have been like 20 when he was in TNA. Holy shit. Are you serious? God damn. Like, he was like an old school TNA guy. That's ridiculous. Oh, he's retired. I don't want retired dudes. God damn it. Why is that a thing? Why is he retired? This looks like a dude I could use. Like, this is a dude where it's like, hey, how about not be retired? Can you do me a favor and, like, not be retired? Fuck. I could use him as an actual wrestler. So I guess it's Tony DeVito. I mean, part of the Baldies in ECW, sure, why not? $400. One of the old ECW guys. Have we used many ECW guys yet? Okay, that's something's up with his skill set. Look at that. He's one of those dudes, like, even though he's 45, like, why is DeVito is like way more DeVito is like way more he seems way more skilled in this game than he should be given any sort of credit for. But sure, why not? I'm not even gonna package him up with a proper gimmick. It's just a one-night deal. Where would he be? Yeah, he'd be set as an opener, so we'll just occasional wrestler since he's just doing a one-night deal. Watch this be like, wait, this match is gonna be like way better than it has any reason to be. I don't know why, but sure. This throwaway match for our champion to squash a guy. Oh, Jack, you found a show that you could actually go to? That sucks that you're in Tokyo at the exact time that, like, any major promotion that, you know, would be cool to go to is gone or... Yeah, they're not... Either they don't have shows or they're on the other side of the deal. That's insane. My brain. We're getting there. We're getting there. Calm your tits. Sherman getting the win. We won't even do an open match. Fuck it. Decisive win. All-out match, why not? They only got like 8 minutes to do. Hawkeye Pro Heavyweight title? Yeah, no, we're not going to put the title in line in this match. We'll give a sign of respect. Because for some reason, Tony DeVito is like way better than he needs to be. So we're going to put him out there with Sherman and Reynolds and see how he hangs. There we go. Sherman and DeVito. Grab mics. And give respect to each other. Reynolds interrupts and runs them down. We'll just do that. Verbally, but they run them down. Oh, you can go to Ice Ribbon. Ice Ribbon's alright. I mean, you remember that video that I posted with the angle with the person being held at gun with the girl being held at gunpoint? That was Ice Ribbon. Plus, Ice Ribbon has a recent Nakajima, so, I mean, I would consider her one of the top talents around. Really depends, I guess. Nakajima is probably the best reason to go. I can't think of too many other reasons. Other than you might have something ridiculous. But yeah, that was when I showed you that video, and there was an angle which literally had a woman held at gunpoint by a man. Yeah. It's pretty near where you're staying. Oh, that's cool. Let's see. Success and success and success. Why not? It's all about entertainment. There you go. Boom. They have a 3-day festival as soon as you land. Shit. Like I said, Arisa Nakajima works mainly for Ice Ribbon, so she's there. Speaking of which, I have her on my short list. I need to maybe bring her in at some point. Okay, so we have that angle. God damn it. Okay, so we've done the Sherman Reynolds deal. We've done the Shirai Sako deal. We haven't done really much of anything with, Omega and Big O yet. It's free, but you have to buy a drink. Fuck it, I'd buy a bunch of drinks. Are you kidding me? Watching fucking ridiculous Joshi wrestling? Like, that's made for booze. Okay, let me see here. I need something backstage. Stardom doesn't have end of August dates. Stardom's really bad about telling you where they're gonna be. Big Omega. But they're facing each other! Let's do Omega and... God damn it. Okay, so it's Tangaloa and... Okay. So here's what I've got. I was thinking about Seedling. Isn't that the same people who do, I don't want to give that... I wouldn't want to give them money personally, because I think that's the same place where Yoshiko wrestles right now. Let me see. Looks like they just got done with maybe some stuff with Nene Takahashi. So that may be one thing. TNA Knockout gets beat up bad at an indie show. I don't know if that was a CD-ling show, whatever. Lenana. Oh, that was WXW. Oh, that was the Wild Samoans, big deal. I mean, it's up to you. Depending on the ticket price, I guess. CD Lenning, or whatever it's called. Fuck 'em. Let me see here. So yeah, Omega and... Fuck it. Okay, we need something for Yano to do. Now, the way I've generally done it with Japanese people is sex appeal, but that's for my girls, so I'm just gonna have it be selling. Why not? Does it work? Omega complains to someone off camera about his match versus Big O. Cam pans over to show... Wow, I screwed that one up. YTR shrugging. There you go. I would just... Something tells me that would just be the greatest thing in the world. Seedling, but it's spelled stupid. Is it really supposed to be spelled Seedling? Because it comes out as like CD Linning or something like that. That's like CD Linning. Like, what the fuck is CD Linning? I'm thinking Dash might also work for CD Lining. I don't even give a fuck if it's not CD Lining. That's the best way I could say it. Or Seedling. Dash might have a match there too. Sendai, Sendai, CD Lining, or Ling, CD, or Seedling, okay, it's Seedling, but it's got like three N's. But hey, the last Seedling event had Dash, so yeah. Maiko Satomura was also there. Nakajima, Hamada, Dash. It doesn't all seem that bad. Satomura, Yoshiko. Seems like decent people who were there last time. Sorry, I got way off track. So yes. Kenny Omega. So this is basically... Let me see if I can... So, Kenny Omega. So yeah, Kenny Omega's complaining to someone backstage. The camera pans over, and this is just what you see. You just see Yano, you just see Toru Yano shrugging. But he's also the hired muscle, so he's like a goofy hired muscle, I guess. But either way, I think that's about... Oh, God. What else have we used people for? Let's see. Bolt Brady needs a match. Matt Hardy, Pete Dunne, Raj Singh. So, Redmond versus Dunne, I think, might main event. So, we can do Hardy. Hardy versus Singh, I guess. It's face versus face, so it really wouldn't work out all that well. Maybe we can find something. Maybe we can find like two jobbers again. We'll just hire some. We'll even hire just good ring workers. How about that? To hire, and they should. You know what? They should probably be active wrestlers. Alex Payne. $80, 5-course meal, and unlimited goods while you watch matches. Huh. Rotten. Isn't Axel Rotten? Axel Rotten's... Yeah, he's dead, isn't he? I think. I just wouldn't feel right using him. I've never heard of some of these guys, by the way. This might give me a chance to look at some of these guys. Chandler McClure. He looks like a douche. He looks perfect. Johnny Riggs. Oh. Johnny Riggs. Let's see. Murdoch. How about that? $290 will get us this douche. And Johnny Riggs. He works as a Japanese junior. Eh, he seems alright. Why not? Oh, you can drink for 2 hours. Damn. $300. Alright. So, just pick up some local guys to job out, that we don't have to use our own guys to make them look terrible. It's probably a good way to do stuff like this. Roster. So, Johnny Riggs. Heel. Come on. And occasional wrestler. And then, who was the other dude? I just hired him. I totally forgot who it was that I already... Chandler McClure. I don't know who Chandler McClure is, but we'll use him. Why do these both... Neither one of these guys look like actual faces. I don't know why they're assigned as faces. What other wrestling promotions exist? Let's see. You've exhausted New Japan, Stardom, DDT, Dragon Gate, Sendai, JWP. I don't know if JWP's doing anything. That might be something. Okay, there we go. So, tag team contest. Two of our big stars that we have nothing for right this second versus two nobodies. Noah. Do you really want to go to Noah and be sad? No, God damn it. 0-1. Who's the one that... Is it 0-1 or is it Wrestle 1 that Aki Bono still works for? There's that. I don't know if Michinoku Pro's doing anything. Let me see here. So Matt Hardy and Rush Singh versus two nobodies. Come on. Chandler McClure and Johnny Riggs. Why not? Big Japan. Couldn't really say too much about Big Japan. I haven't seen one of their recent stuff. Seems like FMW seems to tone down their shit now. Let's see. Not even an open match. Decisive win. Why not? There we go. 10 minutes. Probably even too long for that. There we go. Matt Hardy. Rush Singh. Two guys I got next to nothing for. Technically, I have something for Matt Hardy, but I can't... Like, I already was doing something with Alex Reynolds and... Big O, so I kind of took the hit on the fact that I wasn't really doing much of anything with Ethan Carter that was necessary, so I just kind of took a chance on that. So Matt Hardy, Rush Singh. Hardy and Singh. Let's see. Let's see, the injustices of Bullet Club. How about that? So they're kind of against Bullet Club. So we got people who can... Because I think that's what we've had, is we've had Hardy kind of against them. So now we've got people who are maybe on Tama Tonga's side against Bullet Club. We're definitely doing Dunn versus Redman at the main event. I'm trying to see if there's anything else I want to do. So, let's see. So basically maybe some throwaway Bolt Brady match. Let's see, is there anything we could do with that? Let's see, Bolt Brady, Marty Scurll, Lance and Noah. Juice. We can give Juice a win by beating Bolt Brady. He hasn't gotten a win in the last couple events, so we should probably do that. Oh god, that's probably loud, isn't it? I can already tell. Oh, Jesus. Hang on. There we go. Just have Monster Express just blasting in everybody's ears. No. Okay, so we need... Oh, what was it? Okay, it was Bolt Brady and... Shit, who was I going to have him face? Let's see if I can remember without having to go back. I lost complete track of what I was going to do. Fuck! Brady was in a match, throwaway match. Juice. That's right, that's what we were doing. We wanted Juice to come out and... Juice is backstage cutting a promo about to where he was in the spring. How about that? Because back in March he was fighting for the title. So that's where he wants to get back to where he was. So that's the whole deal that he wants there. BJW is death matches. Oh. Well, yeah, that sounds... Yeah, BJW is mostly death matches. I think FMW's really toned down their stuff. Like, because that used to be FMW the whole time. But I don't know if they do... I don't think they do death matches all the time in FMW anymore. Like, I saw on the... the collection, like, the most recent show... of FMW was... didn't seem all that bad, or at least what I had watched of it. But then again, you might have to, like, really look for... where FMW might... I don't know if they do regular shows anymore. Here we go. Let's see. Juice... Bolt Brady. They're both faces. Oh well, I'll take the hit on it, because we need a little bit of a difference in between all of this. Let's give Juice a nice win here. Storytelling? You know what? This really isn't going to be the storytelling one. We still haven't done really any storytelling ones, besides maybe the opening one, I think. So, we'll make it an open match, why not? And a decisive win. There we go. There we go, just like that. Feels like it's a yellow, so it's I'm missing something. I don't know what I'm missing. I do know I do want another match anyway, so... let's see. Pete Dunne can't really talk too much, can he? Pete Dunne backstage promo. Opportunity tonight. Give it about 2 minutes, I'd say. Entertainment, there we go. Probably not gonna be the highest rated thing ever. Then we move over to Shane Hollister. Hollister comes out before the match to join Eric and Chael at the desk. We're going to get ourselves a little bit of a special guest announcing by the one and only Shane Hollister. BJW DDT and Ice Ribbon. Nice. Sounds like a pretty decent lineup right there. Alright, have I used everyone? Alright, so Pete Dunne versus Joel Redman. Alright, so Pete Dunne. Joel Redman. Joel Redman's carrying an injury, yeah, I know. Shot at winner goes on to face Hollister at end of the road. I think both these guys could probably pull off stamina wise a pretty okay match. Stamina-wise, yes. In fact, Redmond's not the best at chain wrestling, but we might actually try this. So we're going to give him 20 minutes, 21 minutes actually, to put on a technical masterclass. Badly executed of, you know what, I think we might just stick to a storytelling. How about that? I'm not gonna push the issue here. Pete Dunne, yeah, with an injured guy who's not the most technical guy in the world, we won't push it. Make it an open match. Decisive pinfall finish. Distraction on Pete Dunne by Shane Hollister. Still not enough. We are moving and grooving to Shane Hollister versus Pete Dunne. And Hollister is going to join them at the desk there. And I think we've pretty much got it there. You know what? I wanted to slow build this. So there we go. So Dunn versus Redmond, winner goes on to face Hollister at End of the Road. So I think that's about what I want. I want to see if I want to have an ending shot. What does my ending shot look like? How about this? Dunn poses now. Let's just put Dunn celebrates his win while Hollister backs away to the back. I think it's been a little while since we've had someone like Pete Dunne actually. We'll have them both sell. For different reasons. Hollister selling the fact that he basically, maybe over the course of the match, has maybe gotten hit by Pete Dunne when he tried to distract him, got in the way, got a piece of Pete Dunne's boot or elbow, and so he's slinking away, and then Dunne selling his match while he's also celebrating, and that is how that ends. Watch New Japan Cool. Have fun. Is the, it's only 5 o'clock, so the G1 matches aren't quite on yet, I believe. Alright, Mayu Iwatani, Sarah Lee did about as good as you could expect her to do. That's a thing. Io Shirai, Jessica Havoc. I need to check what my pre-booking looks like as well. Because I think I've only got 2 matches set up. Oh no, I did set up the match between Alex Reynolds and Mark Sherman. I just need to put that in there. That's right. He did come out and he named a time and a place. And I didn't even say that. It was going to be End of the Road and it's going to be a ladder match. Sherman versus Reynolds in a ladder match. We'll do that. Am I going to football? Probably. I'll probably do that after this. 63 for Io Shirai versus Jessica Havoc again, so did pretty good, I'd say. There we go. Dash Chisako coming back. A B minus. Holy shit. Dash Chisako's comeback was huge. Holy shit, Dash is back. Redmond and Daria's office. That did pretty well there. Cody Hall versus Yuma did about as well as I'd assume that match would do. Cody Hall, Patrick Clark actually didn't do all that bad. I actually expected that to go worse between the both of them. Katarina Lee cutting a single promo that went kind of eh. Once again, Momo's not the greatest. Katarina Lee was also kind of off her game, but a 44 is still pretty good for Katarina Lee. You can only do so good though when you have someone like Momo. I'm really trying to build up Momo, but I think I pretty much have to relegate her to pre-show if I'm going to use her too much. 59 for the whole female brawl deal. I think I'll wait until next show to officially announce how that how this will be settled. So we got Colby Carino, Cody Hall, of course. Colby confronting Cody Hall in the back. He basically gets shoved away. Yeah, don't turn him yet. Mark Sherman, Tony DeVito did pretty okay. Tony DeVito actually didn't do all that fantastic. I figured it would probably be a little bit better, but either way, it was the talking seemed to be more of DeVito's strong suit, as Alex Reynolds also came to kind of build that up a little bit. I do fully understand that my title situation is a little weak. I think it's mostly due to the fact that Mark Sherman is a mid-carder. Like, since I've been getting, like, he was groomed to be a main eventer, and he didn't, like, he's not quite living up to what I wanted him to be, just because I got so many better guys now. And now Yano's leapfrogged over him, too. But hey, seemed to work out pretty well to have Yano there. I love it that, like, that's his debut. It's just, like, 10 seconds of him, like, shrugging or something. So I haven't even officially used him much of anything yet. 59, actually, for that, let's see how this looked. Riggs and McClure, neither one did fantastic. Raj Singh and Matt Hardy really kept that one up. And then them talking about the Bullet Club. We kind of already did the whole Bullet Club thing, so nothing comes of that right this second. Then we get the throwaway Juice Robinson-Bolt Brady match. Does pretty all right. I think it was kind of brought down by the fact that they're both faces, but did all right. Pete Dunne's promo actually did pretty good. A 64 is quite nice. This is going to be a worse than usual show, I think. I think I'm basically treading water until I can get to end of the road, which I like. There's a lot of things that I'm doing to get to that point. Like, I think right now I do have plans. I'm just making sure I can make it to end of the road because there's so many different changes going on right now. So Shane Hollister coming out to join Eric Bischoff and Chael Sonnen at the desk. Everything seemed to do pretty well. Hollister, of course, tried to involve himself in the Pete Dunne match. A 70, by the way, for Pete Dunne versus Joel Redman did damn nice. So Pete Dunne gets the win, and he's going to be facing, for a fact, book the match, 1v1, right? Yes. There we go. Pete Dunne versus Shane Hollister. Pete Dunne versus Shane Hollister. Shot at the Hawkeye Pro heavyweight title. There we go. So it's not like officially number one contendership. Is Joe Rogan thrown in this? I don't think Joe Rogan is, because he's not really involved with wrestling. Chael Sonnen actually kind of is. So that's kind of the unique thing about Chael Sonnen, is Chael Sonnen is, if they ever do much of anything with Global Force Wrestling, Chael Sonnen is legit, like their color commentator for Global Force Wrestling. They just don't really do much. I want to see if I can find like a real thing about that. But yeah, like, there's a thing on YouTube. That's about it. Yeah, there's a thing. He's been involved. But yeah, okay, so we got three matches planned out. We got that. Let's see, we got Let's have a match booked now so that we have it done. Ladder. Ladder match. Alex Reynolds, Mark Sherman for the title. Hawkeye Pro Heavyweight. There we go. End of the road, Alex Reynolds versus Mark Sherman in a ladder match for the Hawkeye Pro Heavyweight title. Cody Hall versus Patrick Clark. Pete Dunne versus Shane Hollister. One-on-one match shot at the heavyweight, the Hawkeye Pro Heavyweight title on the line. The Big O versus Kenny Omega. Possession of the opportunity trophy is on the of Kenny Omega's opportunity trophy is on the line there. And one match is gonna probably have to get cut because he just hasn't been around. Other than that, I think on the next show for a fact I'm really gonna have to make sure it's booked for sure, because I kind of already have made something of it. Yeah, there's two matches at least left. Three matches left to fully book and have done. Two of them really just need finalized at this point, and then the other needs maybe a couple of angles to really make sure everything's fit in together. So, that ending shot of Pete Dunne seems to really bring up the rest of the show. Man, yeah, the ending, I forgot. The end, they really, it's really weighted. The farther down, the farther up the card you go, the farther, you know, through the show you get, the more weight that there is to the good stuff. So, if you have a great main event and a great ending to your show, then you're going to have a much better show. So, first off, props to Pete Dunne for his performance. Props to Shane Hollister for his performance. And let's see, Matt Hardy. Let's see. Yes, that right to win. Props to EO for pulling off a pretty good match with Jessica Havoc. Damn good match, actually. Pete Dunne seemed pleased. Shane Hollister was pleased. EO Shirai was very happy. All right. Manny Garcia, it's No Way Jose. It's weird to see him as not No Way Jose. But you can totally see it. I wonder if he's No Way Jose. I think he was No Way Jose by the time this version of the mod came out. I think. I'd have to look now. I'm positive that he was No Way Jose at that point. Mephisto extended her deal, and we got a 0.02 TV rating. Awesome. Let me see. WWE Survivor Series. Alright, yeah. Once again, I wanted to check and show how other certain promotions are doing, mostly TNA and WWE. I mostly want to see titles. First of all, Sami Zayn is relegated to the pre-show. It's just disgusting. Let's see. Charlotte's still the women's champion. That rightfully got a 38. Rightfully, a hype video featuring Shinsuke Nakamura and Curtis Axel got a 38. I'm actually kind of surprised that Nakamura was able to get a 69 out of Curtis Axel for the title. I mean, Axel's not that bad, but it's just kind of funny that Nakamura faced Axel for the Intercontinental title. They didn't even put the heavyweight title on the line at Survivor Series. Hype video involving Seth Rollins, Roman Reigns, Dean Ambrose, and Sheamus. Oh, so that was your Survivor Series main event. Wait, what? Who is Dean Ambrose and Sheamus against Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins? Is Reigns like a heel now? At least in this version? It's amazing to think, though. So it's Ambrose and Sheamus versus Reigns and Rollins. That's amazing. Alright. Cool. Fear and Loathing 9. Probably not how the show's actually going to end. But hey, they brought in Doug Williams. I don't know how they would end Fear and Loathing 9. I don't see Grado. Oh, there's Grado. Grado would probably be farther up the card, but eh. There we go. Let's get to the end of the month and we will set out and see financially where we sit. I think we did pretty all right as we're getting towards end of the road. I think my mind is mostly set on getting done with the month, getting through end of the road, and then dealing with all the changes that come with changing after all that. I'm trying to look and make sure if there's something I'm missing out on. Okay. Oh, multi-advance has stopped. Let me see this. By the way, I don't know why I saw this. I just saw Jimmy Rave to Ring of Honor. It's like, wow, good for him for, I guess, getting a job somehow. He's a main eventer for Global Force. What the fuck is Jimmy Rave? Why is Jimmy Rave that big? It's the state of Global Force. He is their global champion. This is Jimmy fucking Rave is your Global Force champion. What the fuck? The state of Global Force wrestling. Okay, what did people want? Pay rise request from Cody Hall. Yeah, that's not much, I guess. You're stopping me to ask for a raise, thanks. Dick. Alright. I want to get through the rest of this. Speaking of porn stars in the wrestling industry, Angela Fong. I guess she really wasn't like a porn star, but she was willing to do nudity in movies. I don't know if she was straight up porn star, but yeah. Oh, she's actually working in Lucha Underground right now. Did not know that. There you guys go. Oh wait, no, David's already gone. Never mind. And okay, multi-event stopped. More people want money. Tama Tonga. Oh my god, a $700 pay rise. Just take $525. God damn, you're just fucking pulling my leg here. You just I feel like I'm being just kind of flipped over and just sort of like shaken down right now. God damn. What does the pay look like for this? Kushida's like 1600, Ethan Carter the Third's like 2200. Holy shit. More and more Tama Tonga just leapt into the $1,000+ territory. Jesus Christ. At least I can still have guys like Yuma working for $200 because he's not all that great. Bolt Brady. Even Dario Cueto's only working for like $440. It's kind of fun. There we go. Come on. Can we just make it to the end of the month? Begging ya. Oh. That's all I want is to get to the end of the month. Just don't throw more shit at me. Don't ask for more money. No more greedy fucks. God damn it. 1690. God damn it. I gotta pay you 15. Please, no more. God, I'm getting shaken down for cash right now. It's like they know. It's like, hey, you know how we're doing really well? Yeah, we're just... Let's just keep that going by getting some more money out of you. It's like, motherfucker. Like, he's just like, hey, man. Oh, God. Okay, this is different. Different. What is this? RevPro made a contract offer to marry Dobson. They're not cult, are they? No. So there's no reason to give a shit about the fact that RevPro wants to hire Mary Dobson. Did they get rid of her? Because I specifically remember her working for RevPro. Like, they must have been like, yo, we want you back. Like, I remember you working for RevPro. Can we please just get me to the end of the month? Let me be done with this. No more money. I'm getting tired. And then I promised football, because I need to stay up. I should have, like, went and got donuts. That sounds great. That sounds like a fat guy thing right now. I could really go for a donut right now. Videos. Unread emails, jump straight to your office? Sure. What do you got? Bobby Fish leaves Ring of Honor. Cool. Trent's completed his tour. Jay Lethal finishes his tour with Wrestle 1. All Japan wants that. The head booker position of AWA. Oh, Awesome Wrestling Association. What the fuck? Is this like something new? Founded December 17. Oh. Owner is Super Delphin. Oh, it's a brand new... Oh, it's a generated... It's a computer... It's a game-generated promotion. I see. Deep-fried pizza. That's what I'm craving. Just want a cream or jelly-filled donut. That just sounds great. Prestige is still at 26. All right, so, yeah. I usually do this because I like to... I used to do this a lot, and then I kind of kept forgetting, because I think I just kept blowing time all the time. Alright, so before I end this, now that we're in a new month, we'll take a look at the damages of everything. Needless to say, we only lost 64 grand, and we spent an odd 130 grand on an arena. We only saved like 4,000 on show costs, so we were set to make like... something in the range of 70, almost 70,000. We were set to make somewhere in the range of like $65,000 this month. Oh yeah, it helps when you own a wrestling hotbed and you can get $20,000 in extra ticket sales to show up, which is really going to help when we start doing TV more. Because it's only a slight bump in sponsors, but we got, like, much more merchandise. We got a huge bump in ticket sales. Everything else, I mean, is pretty par for the course, so... That's pretty good. We were set to make, like, $50,000 this month. Jesus. I should start spending that money on... I think that might be something I'll have to look at some point. I don't know if I could actually edit my venue to include more people. It doesn't seem like it. I would have to, like, sell it and then make a new one with that money. When I eventually get that, like, I'd have to sell it and then make a new venue. Or I could just keep the venue and now I have two venues. I wonder how much it... I just want to see how much it costs to do a 10,000-seater. $280,000 for a 10,000-seat arena. Or if I wanted to do a 1 million... I don't think it's physically possible to do a 1 million-seater. But if I have $10 million at some point, I can just build in this game my own fucking Jerry world, basically. And that's where Hawkeye Pro is eventually going to be, is we're just going to have... We're just... Every day is WrestleMania 32. Alright, so finance-wise, we're at about $57,000, which, you know, it was gonna be even more. I think we did pretty good there. Calendar, some days have opened up. Fuck yes. Does that mean what I think that means? I want to see something. Does that mean what I think that means, EC3? He's still at House of Hardcore. Okay. I want to... Okay, I need to talk to him. Has he put me over... Okay, he's not put me over House of Hardcore yet. Something must have happened. Because there's now officially open days. And I'm not used to open days. We should put on extra shows. I was just thinking about that. Like, we could totally put on, like, 3 shows next month. I don't know. But, either way. Did pretty good there. Size-wise, I think we bumped ourselves up a little bit more in popularity. Still a lot of 2s and 3s here for, our internet audience, but we seem to be gaining, at least with these local TV deals, we seem to be doing slightly better and better in bringing more people in, so we're doing pretty well in that regard. Where we do have TV, we're definitely getting up there. It'll definitely change once we get a TV show. We'll definitely be moving even faster. Which is something I'm looking forward to, because I think, yeah, I need a 47. I'm at a 34 right now in the Midwest, and I really would like to have, I'd really like to get to Cult at some point. Even, like, can you imagine if I get to that by the 3rd anniversary? That'd be kind of nice. Each anniversary is just a new celebration of getting bigger. So yeah, still regional, working our way towards Cult. Got the importance there. Prestige is a 26. Momentum has moved up, I think, from a 60 to a 62. Prestige is still at 26. Rank 37th in the world. I think at one point we were 36th before the last show, but I'm thinking the money might have something to do with why we're down to 37th. But I figure that'll change at some point. And hey, 37th in the world is nothing to sneeze at when it comes to... promotions, so I'm pretty happy about that. I mean, it's a long ways away from being dead last like we used to be. So, doing pretty well here, and next month, we are now in December 2017, next month will be end of the road 2017. I think we're just about done with this portion here. I do have a video to upload. Because I made a video, and I don't know if you guys really want to see it. I don't know how many enough wrestling people that are interested in it. I may just post it to the YouTube channel and have people who are interested in it. I did make myself a slight video for TEW for a returning person, because I've mentioned that I'm... I think at the beginning of the next stream, TEW, I'll be looking into getting people signed from Stardom on a one-night contract, so I can do my special Hawkeye Pro cross-brand Stardom event, which is what I plan on doing. Probably the first one in January, so I'll have to get that set up. And I have a video that I edited quickly. Just for a certain wrestler who was injured as kind of a return promo I'll probably upload that to YouTube at some point. But either way, End of the Road is... I'll be changing the day, but End of the Road is next month. So we're getting towards the end of 2017, and we're getting towards the end of the year. We've got to our next big event, and then we're definitely going to be looking at television. Maybe not next time for certain, but the time after that, I think. We will see. But either way, yeah, like I said, I'll probably be doing something on stream after this. I promised football, so I got to do that. So you guys watching this on stream, thank you very much for coming out for the wrestling. And for you guys watching on YouTube, thank you very much for continuing to watch. I'm grateful that people are, you know, continuing to watch this and that it's still very popular. So thank you guys, and I will see you guys next time.